Dr. K. Thavalingam. He's a retired Survey General of Sri Lanka.
Good evening. Thank you. My camera is not working. So I will do presentation.
Please.
Audio presentation. It's okay.
Time to invest on a camera.
Thank you very much. Yes. So my subject is land, one of the factors of production. So you all know that land is most extensive natural resource in Sri Lanka. For any investment, we should find land whether it is available or not. So total area of Sri Lanka is 6.56 million hectares or 65,610 square kilometers. You go around coastline, it is 1,340 kilometers. Population in 2019, 21.4 million. If you calculate man-land ratio is, if you divide 6.56 million by 21.4 million, that is 0.31 hectares. Man per man land ratio is 0.31 hectares. Utilized land for agriculture and urban purposes nearly 2.7 million hectares. Out of 6.56 million hectares, 2.7 million is used for agriculture and urban purpose. It comes, if you divide that, if you see the land availability per person is, if you divide 2.7 by 21.4, you reach 0.13 hectares. So usable land is only 0.13 hectares. Therefore, the land not available for use is 0.31 minus 0.13 is 0.18 hectares per person. So balanced land is used for reservations, forest reserve, conservation for forest, and then wildlife reserve, archaeological, so on. So those lands are reserved for that. So usable land is only 0.13 hectares per person. So we will see the land utilization in Sri Lanka. In Sri Lanka, agriculture and land, urban, 2.7 million hectares used. That is 35% of the extent of the Sri Lanka. Forest life, forest video, wildlife and catchment area is nearly 2 million, that is nearly 31%. So balance 34% tea, rubber, steep land or slope over 40%. If you consider Northern province, land utilization is agriculture and urban is 322,432 hectares. That is 36% of the land in Jaffna is used for, in the northern province, used for agriculture and urban. In forest, 435,677 hectares. That is 49% of northern province land is forest and other wildlife areas. Water bodies and wetlands is balance is about 15%, that is 133,473 hectares. In population, Jaffna in 2019, 1.143 million, that is 1,143,000. So you see the man-land ratio, it comes to 0.28. Land availability for usage is 0.28 hectares per person. Recent figures shows about 10% of northern population are completely landless people. Nearly 110,000 people, they don't have lands. Always in southern part says forest is 50% of the forest in Sri Lanka is northern province. It is not so, because if you compare this forest in northern province and Sri Lanka, only 22% is in northern province. Balance 78% out of Northern province. Now we will see this, how to use this land. What are the issues when you use this land? We will see that land utilization laws and policies normally reflect the attitudes shown by the policy makers. Those people, policy makers, introduce some laws and policies on land. On the other hand, land laws and policies reflect the attitude of the people on it. So these are two extreme cases. Policy makers use some certain policies to utilize the land, but the general public expect something else. These two are two extreme issues. When the balance between these two is lost, issues relating to land utilizations arise. When these social and economic issues are not solved, it becomes complicated social, economical, and political issues. To solve these issues, the government since 1930 introduced various state policies and laws by implementing schemes like Aloya scheme and so on. However, the contribution made through are not more satisfactory, especially if you consider ethnic issues. Land issue is the biggest issue. Reason because central planning do not adequately represent regional needs. This is the main issue. These unsatisfactory actions lead ethical issues. So to sort out or solve, 13 amendments to the constitution was introduced in 1987. In 13 amendments, certain land powers have been given to provincial council. Land tenure, transfer, and alienation of land, land use, land settlement, and land improvement are all reserved for provincial council. But what has happened is, but still all land powers retained by central government. So this, all these 13 amendments not working in Sri Lanka now, in especially in Northern province. So what is happening is, we are going with old laws related to natural resources. Old laws means land development ordinance, land settlement ordinance, law. So now we will see laws in practice related to natural resources. There are approximately 80 different laws directly affect the management of natural resources. So now we will see the land ownership. There are two ordinances is applicable to separate state land and private lands. This is an issue in Jaffna now. If you take Sundikulam sanctuary, there are a lot of issues. So state land encroachment ordinance in 1840, this is declared state lands to prevent encroachment. Then land settlement ordinance 1931, separate state and private after verification.
Dr. Thavalingam, you can take another minute or two.
Okay. Now there are 8 laws are applicable now. Then land, if you take the land distributions, land 82% state and 18% private. State land 82%, 5% LRC land. If you say LRC land, land reform law was passed in 1972 to vest all excessive lands owned by private parties. So then other state land is, there are several purpose for reservation. Out of 77% reservation, forest, wildlife, so on. Then NHPA, Mahali Authority, and so on. Then Armed Forces, Sports Authority, and CGR. So only usable laws are state land ordinance and land development ordinance. Under this ordinance only, people can get land for their day-to-day work, or these all investment comes under these laws, state land ordinance, commercial purpose, industrial purpose, large scale agriculture, government institutions, and so on. So this is the way land are used in Sri Lanka. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Thavalingam. Very extensive presentation on the Land Act, and you know, it was very eye-opening.